हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू अर्पिता शर्मा क्लासेस। सभी का स्वागत है अर्पिता शर्मा क्लासेस में। आई एम अर्पिता शर्मा, योर एजुकेटर, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू एनालाइज द हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर फॉर 2 मई 2020। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। सो हियर इज अ स्मॉल अनाउंसमेंट, ऑल द पीडीएफ ऑफ द क्लासेस आर अपलोडेड ऑन आवर टेलीग्राम चैनल। क्लास की जितनी भी पीडीएफ्स होती हैं वो हमारे टेलीग्राम चैनल पे अपलोड कर दी जाती हैं। यू कैन डाउनलोड द पीडीएफ्स। The name of my Telegram channel is Simplifying UPSC with Ease. Link is given below in the description box below the video. Link नीचे description box में दिया हुआ है. And the name of the channel is Simplifying UPSC with Ease. Channel का नाम है Simplifying UPSC with Ease. All right. And also another announcement for all of you. I have launched two new courses on Unacademy Plus. मैंने Unacademy Plus पर दो नए courses launch किए हैं. And those two courses are Art and Culture Crash Course and Revising Current Affairs through MCQs. Art and Culture का Crash Course है एक, और एक है Current Affairs Revisionary Course through MCQs. Last one year Current Affairs we are going to revise in that course. If you want to subscribe to Unacademy Plus, you can use my referral code Sharma20 to get 10% discount on your subscription. अगर आप एक महीने, तीन महीने, एक साल या दो साल के लिए Unacademy Plus को subscribe करना चाहते हो, तो आपको 10% डिस्काउंट मिल जाएगा अगर आप ये रेफरल कोड Sharma20 यूज करते हो। एज यू कैन सी दीज आर दी फीडबैक, 100% पॉजिटिव फीडबैक्स ऑन माय कोर्सेज। कोर्सेज पे 100% पॉजिटिव फीडबैक भी आते हैं। सो यू कैन अप्लाई टू दीज कोर्सेज ऑन Unacademy Plus। ऑल्सो आई एम गोइंग टू लॉन्च अ स्पेशल फ्री लाइव क्लास। एक फ्री लाइव क्लास मैं लॉन्च कर रही हूँ कल, दैट इज ऑन 5 मई 2020। Now this live class will be on the strategy to prepare for GS paper 4. GS paper 4 के लिए क्या strategy होनी चाहिए उसके ऊपर ये class होगी, and this class will be conducted at 4 PM free of cost on Unacademy Plus. Unacademy Plus के special live class है ये, free of cost है, right? I will be taking this class live on Unacademy Plus tomorrow. The link is given below in the description box and also in the PDF. PDF में भी link होगा और नीचे description box में भी है. You can register to this particular course. इस course में आप register कर सकते हैं. Okay? So without any delay, let's start the class. Class शुरू करते हैं अपनी. The first important news: lockdown extended till May 17. Curbs stay on public transport. As we all know, lockdown 3.0 आ गया है, right? अब lockdown को May 17 तक extend कर दिया है. Lockdown has been extended to May 17. Now the very first doubt which students have is, ma'am, how to filter news from the newspaper? Now the very important requirement of filtering or studying the newspaper is the syllabus. पहली रिक्वायरमेंट आपकी होती है सिलेबस। इफ यू नो द सिलेबस, ऑब्वियसली यू विल नो व्हाट टू रीड एंड व्हाट नॉट टू रीड। जब आपको सिलेबस पता होगा तो आपको पता होगा कि क्या पढ़ना है क्या नहीं पढ़ना, राइट? सो दैट इज व्हाई कीपिंग अ सिलेबस विद यू, अ कॉपी ऑफ सिलेबस विद यू इज वेरी क्रूशियल एट व्हेन यू प्रिपेयर फॉर यूपीएससी। बहुत ही जरूरी है, बिकॉज द स्टूडेंट्स हु डू नॉट हैव द सिलेबस, हु हैव नॉट लुक्ड एट द सिलेबस, दोज आर द वेरी स्टूडेंट्स हु से दैट यूपीएससी सिलेबस इज वेरी वास्ट। वही बच्चे, वही स्टूडेंट्स जिनके पास सिलेबस की कोई समझ, कोई कुछ भी कह सकते हो आप, समझ नहीं होती, कोई अंडरस्टैंडिंग नहीं होती, वही बच्चे बोलते हैं कि यूपीएससी का सिलेबस तो काफी वास्ट है। यूपीएससी सिलेबस इज वेल डिफाइंड एंड इन लिमिट्स इफ यू हैव स्टडीड इट। अगर आपने सिलेबस देखा है तो आपको पता होगा, राइट? सो दिस पर्टिकुलर न्यूज इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर प्रिलिम्स, मेंस एंड इंटरव्यू। प्रिलिम्स के लिए भी इंपॉर्टेंट है, मेंस के लिए तो है ही है, और इंटरव्यू के लिए भी काफी इंपॉर्टेंट है। Now here you have to study about coronavirus, common types of coronaviruses, symptoms, disease caused by this spread and treatment. What is community transmission? Community transmission से रोकने की कोशिश हो रही थी, जो कि कोशिश नाकाम रही। तो community transmission क्या है? What is it? That is important for your prelims. And impact of lockdown on various sections is important for your GS paper 3. Now the service sector, right? The health infrastructure, everything has been impacted. So that you have to study. क्लियर एवरीवन? इतना सबको क्लियर हो गया? सो नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इज, ये तो पहली न्यूज है, ये दिस इज द फर्स्ट न्यूज विच हैज बीन इन न्यूज एंड वी हैव कवर्ड दिस अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम्स। सो दीज आर द क्वेश्चंस वेयर विच ऑन विच यू हैव टू पॉन्डर ऑन। नाउ द सेकंड इज, हेल्थ मिनिस्ट्री आइडेंटिफाइज 130 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स एट एज रेड जोन्स। 130 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स को रेड जोन्स की कैटेगरी में डाला है हेल्थ मिनिस्ट्री ने, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। यूनियन हेल्थ मिनिस्ट्री हैज डेजिग्नेटेड ऑल द मेजर मेट्रोपॉलिटन सिटीज लाइक दिल्ली, मुंबई, चेन्नई, कोलकाता, हैदराबाद, बेंगलुरु एंड अहमदाबाद एज रेड जोन्स। तो अब इन सभी मेट्रोपॉलिटन सिटीज को रेड जोन्स की कैटेगरी में डाल दिया है इन द न्यू लॉकडाउन। And centers also are, the Union Health Ministry has also asked the states and local bodies to demarcate containment areas and buffer zones for strict monitoring of the movement. UP and Maharashtra have also the highest number of red zones at 19 and 14, followed by Tamil Nadu, 12 and districts, 11 districts in Delhi. Among Delhi suburbs, Faridabad, Gautam Buddh Nagar, Meerut, they have been classified as red zones. Underline this. दिल्ली के जो आसपास के एरियाज हैं, सबर्ब्स हैं, उसमें फरीदाबाद आता है, गौतम बुद्ध नगर और मेरठ जो है उनको रेड जोन्स, स्ट्रिक्ट रेड जोन्स की कैटेगरी में डाला है. गुड़गांव एंड गाजियाबाद आर इन द ऑरेंज जोन, बट फरीदाबाद, गौतम बुद्ध नगर एंड मेरठ आर इन द रेड जोन्स. ऑल ऑफ मुंबईज सबर्बन एरियाज हैव बीन क्लासिफाइड एज रेड जोन. दिल्ली के तो कुछ सबर्बन एरियाज को रेड जोन में डाला है, मुंबई के तो सभी एरियाज को रेड जोन में डाला गया है. बेंगलुरु अर्बन एंड रूरल एरियाज एज वेल एज मैसूरू हैव बीन क्लासिफाइड एज रेड जोन्स राइट नाउ. Direct taxes revenues, they defy lockdown jump 36.6% in April. So here, as you can see on screen, पे आप देख सकते हैं, direct tax collection recorded healthy growth in April despite the nationwide lockdown. अब direct tax का जो collection है हमारी country का, वो उसमें increment देखने को मिला है April में, भले ही lockdown लगा हो. Despite of the fact that India was under lockdown, still direct tax increment has been seen 36.6%. It's a healthy growth which has been seen in direct tax collection. The outlook for indirect tax collection remains very bleak. Direct tax का collection rate तो बहुत ही सही है, but the indirect tax collection rate, it is bleak right now, right? Report suggests that GST collection could decline drastically. So over here, only you can say progress has been seen in the direct tax collection. Direct tax collection में progress हमें देखने को मिली है, बाकी में तो हम downfall ही देख रहे हैं. No form gate at Thrissurpuram this year. So Thrissurpuram, what is it? It is important for prelims. ये आपके prelims के लिए काफी important है, right? Very important for your prelims. So the Thrissurpuram is known for its 36-hour long celebrations, which include the Kodiyettam, that is flag hoisting ceremony, rituals with accompaniment of percussion instruments like tabla or elephants parading, right? So ye 36-hour long festival hai. It is an annual festival of which state? Of Kerala. Remember this for prelims. Prelims ke liye yaad rakhna. They can give you the names of three festivals. Aapko festivals ke naam de denge and they will give you the name of the states in which these festivals are celebrated. Then they will ask you which one of them is correctly matched. इसमें से कौन सा correctly matched है, ऐसे पूछेंगे. So Thrissurpuram is part of Kerala. It's a annual festival of Hindu festival of Kerala. Okay. Then now there are 10 participating temples in this festival. But right now, because of lockdown and coronavirus, this festival is not being celebrated properly as it should be. Adopt a cobra for 2,000 rupees and elephant for 1.75 lakh. So would you like to adopt an Indian cobra for as low as 2000 per annum or an Asiatic elephant at 1.75 lakh? So Bengaluru's Banerghatta Biological Park has a new program. Bengaluru ka ye jo park hai, isne ek naya program launch kiya hai. For people with an interest in conserving the wildlife by adopting animals at the zoo. Right? So here you have to remember that this particular national park or biological park belongs to which state. Aapko ye yaad rakhna hai ki ye kaun se state ko belong karta hai. For prelims, it is very, very important. The Banerghatta National Park, it is located near Bangalore. In which state? In Karnataka. Write it down, please. Isko please likh lijiye. Wildlife like elephants, gaur, leopard, jackal, fox, wild boar, sloth, bear, sambar, chittal, spotted deer, barking deer, common langur, bonnet, macaque, porcupine, all these are found in abundance in this particular park. And this park has been integral part of Banerghatta National Park. Ye jo biological part hai na, पार्क है, ये नेशनल पार्क बनेरघट्टा नेशनल पार्क का एक पार्ट है. बनेरघट्टा बायोलॉजिकल पार्ट इज पार्क इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द नेशनल पार्क एंड इट इमर्ज्ड आउट एज एन इंडिपेंडेंट एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ड्यूरिंग द ईयर 2002. क्लियर एवरीवन? सो दिस बायोलॉजिकल पार्क, इट इज अमंग द फ्यू प्लेसेस इन द वर्ल्ड, नॉट इन इंडिया, इन वर्ल्ड, वेयर वाइल्डनेस इज प्रिजर्व्ड सो क्लोज टू अ बिग सिटी. It is having different units like zoo, safari, butterfly park, rescue center. All of these centers are part of this particular biological park. So this is important for your prelims. Now this editorial is very important from GS paper 3's perspective. It's about food, nutrition and livelihood security. This editorial throws a light. ये जो editorial है ये light throw कर रहा है किसके ऊपर? On what topic? About the current national lockdown to tackle the COVID-19 pandemic. And the problems of food, nutrition, livelihood, security, confrontation, large number of rural people. अब ये जो lockdown हुआ है, इससे food की problems निकल के आई है, nutrition की problems निकल के आई है, राइट। सो इन सभी प्रॉब्लम्स पे ये एडिटोरियल एक लाइट आप कह सकते हो डालने की कोशिश कर रहा है। दिस एडिटोरियल हैज बीन को रिटन बाय एम एस स्वामीनाथन एंड नित्या राव। एम एस स्वामीनाथन के जितने भी एडिटोरियल्स होते हैं वो आपको जरूर पढ़ने चाहिए। ही इज अ वेरी एमिनेंट एग्रीकल्चरल साइंटिस्ट एंड फाउंडर ऑफ एम एस स्वामीनाथन रिसर्च फाउंडेशन ऑल्सो। सो एनी एडिटोरियल रिटन बाय एम एस स्वामीनाथन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, उसको तो आपको पढ़ना ही चाहिए, राइट, क्लियर। एंड नित्या राव इज ऑल्सो प्रोफेसर एट जेंडर एंड डेवलपमेंट एट द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ ईस्ट एंग्लिया नॉर्थविक यूके। सो दिस एडिटोरियल इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर इंटरव्यू एंड मेन्स, मेन्स के लिए बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है। Now there are some measures over here, you can see it is written, right, इधर लिखा हुआ है। While some measures have been announced like provision of additional rice or wheat, some pulses and oil free of cost, as well as 1,000 rupees cash for purchase of other essential commodities through public distribution system, we need to understand different dimension of food security in a very complete holistic manner to address this problem which has been in the forefront because of the complete shutdown and lockdown, right? Now availability of food is the first problem, right? Over here, this paragraph, the availability of food in the market is seen as a function of production, right? Food availability जो होती है, this is the first is the availability of food in the market. यहाँ से लिया हुआ है, this paragraph I've taken from here, right? Just look at this paragraph. The availability of food in the market, this has been seen as a function of production. Production चलता रहता है तभी food available रहता है. When the production is going on, only then the food is available. Right or wrong? Right na? So the availability of food in the market is seen as a function of production. Owing to the green revolution, today India has enough food in the market. अगर हम green revolution को हम सारा credit दें, तो अभी फिलहाल भारत में food production में इतनी दिक्कत नहीं है, right? The government go downs are full of the stack. This is a great accomplishment by Indian farmers who converted ship to mouth goods straight off from ship to the mouth of consumer situation to the right to food commitment. Farmers' contribution in terms of sustainable production must not be taken for granted. Though a few special exemptions have been given to agricultural sector, but still farmers are confronted with many problems. भले ही इस lockdown में कुछ exception दे दी है हमने agricultural sector को sustain करने के लिए, but still farmers are haunted with many problems. Like first of them is labor shortage. पहली तो problem है labor shortage की. Many of the inputs including seeds having unavailable, being unavailable, marketing arrangements including supply chains not being fully functional, pricing not being remunerative, public procurement not being adequate. These are the few problems which the agriculture sector is facing right now. Plus there is no room for complacency also, right? Then when we talk about access to food, जब हम access to food की बात करते हैं over here, access to food is a function of purchasing power. So see over here you can see availability food, it is seen as function of production. This is important for prelims, isko likh lo please. Food ki availability production ka function hoti hai, and access to food is a function of, it is a function of purchasing power. Ab kaun access kar payega wo purchasing power pe depend karta hai na. Who will access, who can access the food depends on the purchasing power, right? Fortunately, government through the NFSA, that is National Food Security Act, and PDS, they have assured some additional food to every individual during this lockdown. This should be further strengthened and the food basket widened by including millets, pulses, and oil. Steps should also be taken to avoid hidden hunger caused by deficiency of micronutrients. That means the access to food which is being provided by the government to people, it should also contain the micronutrients which are required in order to make sure that nobody is hungry. No, there is no hidden hunger. In light to the closure of schools and Anganwadi centers, consequent disruptions in provision of midday meals or other nutritional inputs, it is important to pay attention to the life cycle approach advocated in the National Food Security Act. Next important point over here is focus on the non-food factors and work under MGNREGA. So currently a lot of people employed both on farms and in non-farm sector are without jobs. Lockdown ke wajah se jitne bhi log jo farm sectors ya non-farm sectors mein employed hai unke paas job nahi hai. So if this job security is threatened, then so is the food and nutrition security. When there is no job, obviously the nutrition security is also at risk. Nutrition security bhi risk pe aa jayegi. So one way of doing this, first is making sure that people do not lose their job. Pehla step hona chahiye ki logon ki job na chute. And how can we make sure that this happens, that people do not lose their job? One way of doing this will be to ensure value addition to primary products. For example, the example of such value addition is Rice Biopark in Myanmar, wherein straw, bran and the entire biomass are utilized. This would mean some attention to an investment in new technologies that can contribute to biomass utilization. Amul model provides a good example from the dairy sector of improved incomes to milk producer through value addition. Similar attention needs to be given to the horticulture sector also. Fruits वगैरह का जो sector होता है वो horticulture होता है. Women farmers are at the forefront of horticulture and special attention needs to be given to both their technological and economic empowerment during this particular crisis. So basically, through a combination of farmers cooperation, technological upgradation, favorable public policies in procuring, pricing and distribution, India can deal with this particular loopholes of the pandemic or the lockdown. हमें farmers का cooperation चाहिए, technological upgradation चाहिए, digital skills impart करनी है, public policies को favorable बनाना है, तभी जाकर हम इस तरीके के situation से बाहर निकल पाएंगे. Next important editorial is Taiwan's coronavirus protocol shows how it is done. So editorial talks about, ये जो editorial है, ये किस बारे में बात करता है? It talks about, just give me a second. This editorial talks about Taiwan's strategy. ये Taiwan की strategy के बारे में बात करता है, right? Taiwan's strategy in containment of spread of COVID-19 and its strategic preparedness to the threat of emerging infectious disease. Despite its proximity to China, Taiwan ranked 123 among 183 countries in terms of confirmed cases per million people. So this has shown that Taiwan's aggressive efforts to control epidemic are working. Taiwan China se kitna close hai. Still, use 183 countries mein se 123rd rank mila hai. Right, in terms of confirmed cases per million. So Taiwan ka jo effort hai COVID-19 ko contain karne ka, wo bahut hi zyada is waqt popular chal raha hai, right? Right now the effort which Taiwan is putting in order to control or contain this virus, it is going on very well. So we should learn something from Taiwan. Now what is Taiwan's strategy? How they are using technology, right? What is the global linking and beyond? We are going to study in the next few slides. Now when we all know that the novel form of pneumonia that first emerged in Wuhan, this is again important for prelims, I'm highlighting. जो पहला फॉर्म था निमोनिया का वो कब कहां इमर्ज हुआ था? वुहान में एट द एंड ऑफ 2019, राइट? इट हैज बीन सिंस बीइंग क्लासिफाइड एज कोरोना वायरस डिजीज 2019, और इसी को जो निमोनिया के रूप में निकल कर आया था यही कोरोना वायरस डिजीज अब बन चुका है. दिस इमर्ज एज अ निमोनिया फॉर्म ऑफ निमोनिया एंड नाउ इट हैज यू कैन से टर्न्ड इनटू कोरोना वायरस एंड इट इज अ नाउ ग्लोबल पेंडेमिक, महामारी बन गया है. सो द थ्रेट ऑफ इमर्जिंग इन्फेक्शियस डिजीज to global health and economy, trade and tourism has not subsided. Among the most salient examples are the Spanish flu of 1918. Now, coronavirus ka jab bhi baat hoti hai, hum Spanish flu yaad aata hai. Everybody is referring to 1918 Spanish flu. So you have to remember this for prelims. Ye aapke prelims ke liye important ho jata hai. The severe acute respiratory syndrome outbreak also was done in 2003. Came out in 2003. H1N1 influenza of 2019, सबको याद है, सब डर गए थे उस टाइम पर. Intermittently serious regional epidemics like Middle East respiratory syndrome like MERS which emerged in 2012, Ebola which came in 2014, Zika virus which came in 2015-16 were also seen. Question on Zika virus was asked in 2017 prelims. क्वेश्चन आया था जीका वायरस के ऊपर. सो मर्स, सार्स, एबोला, जीको वायरस, स्पेनिश फ्लू, कोविड-19, ऑल ऑफ दिस यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर फॉर प्रीलिम्स. प्रीलिम्स के लिए सब प्रिपेयर करने होंगे. पैंडेमिक्स कैन स्प्रेड रैपिडली अराउंड द वर्ल्ड बिकॉज द ईज ऑफ इंटरनेशनल ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. क्राइसिस एनीवेयर रेडिली बिकम्स अ प्रॉब्लम एवरीवेयर. देखो आजकल राइट नाउ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन हैज बिकम सो इजी. इंटरनेशनल ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, डोमेस्टिक ट्रांसपोर्टेशन हैज बिकम सो इजी एंड एक्सेसिबल दैट दीज वायरसेस कैन बी इजीली ट्रांसमिटेड अक्रॉस द बॉर्डर्स ऑल्सो. सो वॉट इज ताइवान्स स्ट्रैटेजी राइट नाउ? इन 17 ईयर्स सिंस इट वॉज हिट हार्ड बाय सार्स आउटब्रेक, Taiwan has been in a state of constant readiness to the threat of emerging infectious disease. SARS ka outbreak bhi Taiwan ne jhela tha. Taiwan handled the SARS outbreak also. That is why it has prepared itself well for any new infectious disease. Tabhi se unhone khud ko prepare karna shuru kar diya. And this can be seen in the current way also in which it is handling COVID-19. As a result, when information concerning this particular COVID-19 was confirmed in December, Taiwan began implementing on-board quarantine of direct flights from Wuhan. Subsequently, Taiwan established a response team for the disease also, activated Central Epidemic Command Center also as a level 3 of government entity, further upgraded it to level 2 and level 1. The CECC, that is the Center Epidemic Command Center, it is able to effectively integrate resources from various ministries and invest itself fully in containing the epidemic. You can see India can learn a lot from this. हम भी शुरू में टेस्टिंग तो कर रहे थे जो भी एयरपोर्ट से आ रहा है, बट हम सीरियसली हैंडल नहीं कर रहे थे इन द स्टार्टिंग. जैसे अभी कर रहे हैं वैसे अगर हमने बिल्कुल स्टार्टिंग में कर लिया होता तो अभी काफी हद तक हमने प्रोटेक्ट कर लिया होता, कंटेन कर लिया होता. राइट, क्लियर एवरीवन? इतना सबको क्लियर हो गया. ताइवान हैज इंप्लीमेंटेड अ डायनामिक प्लान कंसर्निंग बॉर्डर क्वारंटाइन मेजर्स इंक्लूडिंग ऑन बोर्ड क्वारंटाइन, फीवर स्क्रीनिंग, हेल्थ डिक्लेरेशन, 14 डे होम क्वारंटाइन फॉर पैसेंजर्स अराइविंग फ्रॉम नेशन. And all of this we have also done, but at the later stages. Taiwan did it from the very start only. Taiwan ne jaisi khabar aayi thi tabhi shuru kar diya tha. Taiwan established an electronic system for entry quarantine also. Under this particular system, passengers are allowed with a local mobile phone number to fill in health information using a mobile phone. Health declaration is issued as a text message. फिर उनका जो health declaration होता है वो text message के form में show किया जाता है. This is connected to community care support management system, which allows government agencies to provide care services and medical assistance. Everything is displayed or everything is communicated online digitally. Digitally sab kuch display kar diya jata hai, right? So this is one of the best strategies you can see. For those undergoing home quarantine or isolation, the government is working with telecom operators to allow GPS tracking of their location as well. Quarantine offenders are subject to fines or mandatory placement according to relevant laws and regulation. Taiwan has increased its lab testing capacity as well. So surveillance or inspection badh gaya hai, right? And there are other measures also which has been undertaken by Taiwan. It has banned the export of surgical mask. It has requested the mask and expanded domestic mask प्रोडक्शन. उन्होंने बोला है कि डोमेस्टिक मास्क प्रोडक्शन को एक्सपेंड करो क्योंकि हमें केयरफुल रहना है कि हमारे हाथ हमारे मुंह को टच ना करें. वी हैव टू बी केयरफुल दैट आवर हैंड्स आर नॉट टचिंग आवर फेस. फॉर दैट इट इज नॉट मैंडेटरी टू वेयर द सर्जिकल मास्क ओनली, यू कैन वेयर द डोमेस्टिक मास्क ऑल्सो. दिस हैज हेल्प्ड इट अचीव एन इफेक्टिव एलोकेशन ऑफ लिमिटेड रिसोर्स. ताइवान हैज फुलफिल्ड इट्स रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज एज अ ग्लोबल सिटीजन एंड इट अबाइड्स बाय इंटरनेशनल हेल्थ रेगुलेशन 2005 ऑल्सो. That means it is notifying WHO of the confirmed cases very honestly. बहुत ही honestly अपना data छुपाए बिना WHO को notify भी कर रहा है कि कितने cases confirmed हैं यहाँ पर. Taiwan has communicated with other countries also to share the travel information etc. Taiwan has uploaded genetic sequence of COVID-19 to GIZ initiative, the global initiative on sharing all influenza data. So these are the very beautiful and very impressive steps taken by Taiwan in order to contain this disease. Taiwan, though not a member of WHO, cannot stand alone and must be included in the fight. Taiwan has long been excluded from WHO, but right now, after looking at these positive steps and very speedy implementation of ideas, it is speculated that Taiwan soon will become a member of WHO. Next important news, economist call for urban job scheme. The Urban Employment Guarantee Scheme, new Urban Employment Guarantee Act is needed to complement the existing rural job scheme during ongoing COVID-19 crisis. So what is this? Given that a significant number of migrants are returning to small towns and have lost their livelihoods, there is a need for an urban job program. देखो कितने लोग हैं लॉकडाउन की वजह से जो शहर से निकल के घर वापस जा रहे हैं, गांव वापस जा रहे हैं. There are so many people, migrants, laborers who are going back to their home, to their rural areas, villages. A new Urban Employment Guarantee Act is needed to complement existing rural jobs and rural job scheme during the ongoing COVID-19 crisis. So these types of schemes or new act, Urban Employment Guarantee Act, will make sure in the future that people do not run away from their jobs and migrate back to their villages, right? Jisse economic mein santulan bana rahe. So over here you can see a new Urban Employment Guarantee Act is needed to complement existing rural job scheme. In a letter sent to Rural Development Minister Narendra Singh Tomar, they have asked for MGNREGA funding to be increased to at least 1 lakh crore for next 3 months. The group has also recommended relaxation of 100 days of work per household limit, suggesting that all individuals who wish to work under the scheme be given employment for as many days as needed. The economist also asked for full minimum wage in cash as well as dry rations to be paid to workers within 7 days rather than the current 15-day limit, so that the scheme can meet the need of people. Biometric based payment system should be avoided for now. noting that bank account payments would only cause overcrowding in rural banks, which we have to avoid in the lockdown. Also, people prevented from working during the pandemic due to medical advisories, including those aged over 50, disabled and sick, and pregnant women should be paid full wages for the duration of the restriction, that is lockdown. So COVID-19 jo hai, this COVID-19 pandemic and national lockdown in place have led to an unprecedented unemployment crisis, as we all know. Especially this crisis is being faced by the unorganized sector. A leading group of development activists, they have, and the economist also, they have urged the rural development minister for changes in the Magnarega scheme. The changes are, Magnarega funding should be increased to at least 1 lakh crore for the next 3 months. Second changes they are asking for is relaxation of 100 days of work limit. Right now it is, 100 days ka work limit jo laga tha, usko kam karne ki baat ki gayi hai, kyunki migration ho raha hai. Given that a large number of migrants returning from cities to villages may not have Magnarega job cards, anyone wanting work should be given a job with card registration made available on the site. Payments are to be made in cash and full minimum wages should be paid within 7 days rather than current 15-day limit. So these are the changes which these group of economists and development activists have requested and urged the rural development minister. WHO raises concern over the use of BCG vaccine. In a letter published in the Lancet, WHO, that is World Health Organization Director General Tedros, have highlighted a few critical issues over the use of BCG vaccine for COVID-19. They underscore the importance of randomized controlled trials of the vaccine to understand its safety and efficacy before using it on healthcare workers. So let us see what is BCG vaccine. Ye BCG vaccine hai kya dekhte hain? It is primarily used to protect children against TB in high-risk countries. Jitni bhi high-risk countries hain, usme TB se protect karne ke liye bachchon mein yeh vaccine use hoti hai. It gives early in, given if given early in life, it helps improve the immune system and has been proved to be effective in preventing intracellular infections. Kisi bhi tarike ka intracellular infection bhi prevent karta hai aur immune system ko bhi boost karta hai. Now, how this vaccine is being used in COVID-19 and how much it is effective? A study has found an association between countries that have a universal BCG vaccine and reduced coronavirus case and death. Study notes that BCG vaccine, by enhancing the innate immune response to subsequent infection, helps reduce viral load after SARS-CoV-2 exposure. ऐसा studies में देखा गया है कि ये जो vaccine है, ये immune system के response को तो बढ़ाती ही बढ़ाती है, बल्कि viral load जो होता है उसको भी कम करती है, resulting in more rapid recovery. This has led to further research to conclusively prove that efficacy of BCG vaccine against COVID-19. Randomized controlled trials are underway right now in Netherlands and Australia. The trials and the experiments are going on to test the performance of this particular vaccine. We hope positively ki ye vaccine experiments mein bhi acche se perform kare aur baki mein baki countries ko bhi help kare. The WHO has expressed few critical issues over the use of BCG, but WHO ने थोड़े से critical issues को express किया है. The study establishing the relation between fever COVID-19 cases and universal BCG vaccination program, it is based on population rather than individual data. The BCG vaccine is given at birth and it is unlikely to reduce the severity of COVID-19. देखो जब बच्चा छोटा होता है तब immunity develop करने के लिए दिया जाता है. अब हम बड़े हो गए हैं इतने, तो अब ये reduce कर पाएगा इसकी severity को या नहीं 10 साल बाद, decades later, ये question mark है इसके ऊपर. There is also the possibility that the beneficial off-target effects of BCG vaccine might have been altered by subsequent administration of different vaccine. SARS novel coronavirus induces cytokine storm in some patients, leading to complications and even death. BCG vaccine may ramp up the immune system also, right? It could affect the vaccine supply. The use of vaccine without evidence of its benefits could affect the vaccine supply to protect children against TB. अब मान लो इसका proven result नहीं आया इस vaccine का, फिर भी इस vaccine को हमने इसके use को approval दे दिया, तो क्या होगा? तो क्या होगा? इससे ये होगा कि बच्चों को जो news, बच्चों को जो vaccine की जरूरत है, right? उसमें कमी आ जाएगी, right? TB के जो patients हैं, उनमें कमी आ जाएगी. So it can affect the supply to those patients who really need it. Now also WHO has underscored the importance of randomized controlled trials of BCG vaccine to understand its safety and efficacy before using it on the healthcare workers. Alright, सो दिस वॉज ऑल फॉर टुडे. आई होप यू एंजॉयड टुडेज क्लास. सभी को आज की क्लास समझ आई हो, अच्छी लगी हो. इफ यू रियली एंजॉयड इट, वॉट यू हैव टू डू इज यू हैव टू क्लिक ऑन द लाइक बटन, शेयर दिस क्लास विद अदर एस्पिरेंट्स एंड subscribe to my channel. Also, we are keeping a like target of 50 likes in this particular class. इस क्लास में हम 50 likes का like target रखते हैं. Let's see if we are able to achieve it. You can join or register in this free special live class which I am going to take on Unacademy Plus tomorrow, that is on May 5. And this class will be on how to prepare GS paper 4. Thank you and have a beautiful day ahead.